Hello friends, welcome back. In this video, we are going to study strongly typed HTML helper, one more category of built-in HTML helper in MVC. So as I told you in my introductory lecture of HTML helper, that strongly typed HTML helpers are associated with strongly typed views. Okay, but this is not the only reason of using the strongly typed HTML helper. Now let us see one more strong reason of using strongly typed input helper. So whenever we define standard HTML helper, okay, while defining a standard HTML helper, we specify one string argument. Okay, we specify one string argument, and that string argument is used to search a view data, view bag, or view model to find a corresponding data item. Okay. For your input element, means along with view bag we specify a key, along with view data we specify a key, and in our view model we specify a property. Okay, so what MVC does, whatever string argument you specified to your standard HTML helper, okay, so that argument is searched in view bag, view data, and view model property, okay, to retrieve a value from it and to assign it to your input element. Okay, your input element can be anything: text box, password, checkbox, radio button, anything. Okay, so therefore there will be many permutations. Okay, it will first check for view data, then view bag, then your model properties. Okay, so there will be many permutations, and definitely it will be time consuming. Okay, and once it found the value, then that search will be terminated. Okay, now to avoid this overhead, strongly typed helpers are used. Okay, to avoid this overhead, strongly typed HTML helpers are used. So let me show you this part practically. Okay, so in last video we studied the concept of standard HTML helper, right? Now let us have a look to our login screen or login view. Okay, our login view has one text box. Okay, and what is the string argument to it? String argument is username. Now what will I do? I'll create one view bag key and I'll name it as username, and I assign some value to it. I assign some value to it. Now let us run this and let us see what happens. Okay, my purpose is nothing. I am just passing some data to my view bag. Okay, and what we are going to do, we'll see what is the result. But just remember that the name of our text box is also what? Username. What happened here? Whatever key value I specified in my view bag, it get assigned to my text box, because as I told you, what MVC does, whatever name you have specified to your input element, okay, text box is what? Text box is your input element. Okay, it will search this name in view bag, view data, and your model properties to get a value from it, and if it get the value, then that value will be assigned to your input element. Okay, so to avoid this searching, we use strongly typed helpers. Let us continue with this. So strongly typed helpers are used for this purpose. I hope you understand this. Okay, now one more limitation is that if you are using strongly typed views, then only you can use strongly typed helpers. Otherwise you cannot use strongly typed helpers. Okay, if your view is not strongly typed, then you cannot use strongly typed helpers. Now strongly typed input helpers works on lambda expression. Okay, so you should be familiar with C sharp part, that is lambda expression. Okay, now this lambda expression has pass a value. Okay, and that value or that argument is of type your view model object. Okay, or you can say the argument of your lambda expression is of view model type. I hope you understand this. Okay, and you can select the field or property that will be used to set a attribute. Okay, how it works, I'll show you practically. Now, first of all, we'll see what are the available strongly typed input helpers. So, for checkbox, there is checkbox for. Okay, the difference between standard and strongly typed HTML helper is that for standard helper, you just write checkbox. And for strongly typed helpers, you will write checkbox for. Okay, now this is the lambda expression. Okay, and here you specify one argument, and this argument is of type what? Of type model or of type view model. You can call it as model or view model, do not matter. So whatever model you declared in your view, this M will be of that type and is approved, or here it is ID, here it is password, here it is bio. So all these are what? These are the properties of your model. These are properties of your model. Now for hidden field, you have to use html.hiddenfor. Okay. For radio button, you have to use radio button for. Okay. And if you want to, definitely for radio button, we specify the value. So you have to pass your value as a second argument. Then for password, it is password for. For text box, it is for text area, it is text area for. For text box, it is text box for, and for label, it is label for. Now, there is a HTML helper for your drop-down list and as well as for your list box. Okay, but as I told you in standard helper also, we are going to cover this part in a separate video because this part is little bit complicated. I'm going to show you the multiple ways of populating a drop-down list. So let us see these input helpers, okay, in detail and practically. Okay, so let us switch to our Visual Studio. Now, since we are going to study strongly typed helpers, and according to the requirement of strongly typed helpers, we need one model. Okay, you can call it as view model also. So let me create one model. So here I'm going to create a registration screen. So I'll create a model for that. Say register. Let us call it as view model because it is going to be represent your view. So register view model. Now what your model can contain? It will have one name property of type string, then email property of type string, then string password property, okay, then confirm password, then say care, say gender, then prop string address, okay, and prop bool is agree. Okay, now these are my fields of register view model. Okay, now we are going to design a view that will accept this input, and we are going to design a view using strongly typed HTML helpers. Okay, so let us create one method that will render this view. So public view result, say register. Okay, this is my get method. Now let us create a view. Okay, let it be register. Now, here we are going to design a form. So for form, I'm going to create, or I'm going to use html.beginForm. And I already explained this concept in standard HTML helper. If you are not aware, please watch that video. Okay, so using begin form, we created a form tag. Okay, this closing curly bracket will automatically render a closing form tag. Now, to this begin method, I do not provide anything. I do not provide the action name and controller name. So what it means, it will post back to the same action. Means it will post back to the account controller's register action. So what we have to do, we have to create one overload of our register method, and this time we are going to accept an entire model. Okay, and we saw this concept of model binding also, so we are going to use complex model binding. So what is my model? Register view model, and let me declare an object of it. So for this I have to include the namespace. So I included this namespace here, this one, helper demo dot models. Now since it is overload, let me make this action as http post. Okay, now time being I'm just going to write return view. So we completed with our action methods. Now let us create a view. And this time, since we are going to use strongly typed helpers, I have to make my view strongly typed view by this declaration. So I'll get an advantage of IntelliSense also. So my application name is helper demo dot models dot register view model. Now the next step, we are going to design a form using bootstrap classes or applying bootstrap classes. So form group, and now I'm going to create a vertical form only. Okay, I'm not going to add a complexity of horizontal form here. My suggestion is to try it yourself. Okay, convert same example but apply the horizontal form classes to it. Now next is label. Now for label also I am going to use helper. So label for, now see, m goes to m dot name. Okay, in this way you have to use your helper. Now this m is of type, if you look at here, m is of type what? Look at this gray part. M is of type register view model, means this, whatever model declaration you will do here, this m will be of that type. And for which property you are generating a label, you have to specify it here. Simple. Now let us define a text box for it. So html dot text box for, again we have to specify the model object and the property name. And here I am going to apply one HTML class, CSS class, and it will be specified by anonymous class. So @ class is equal to form dash control. This is my CSS class. So why anonymous class is used, why @ class is written, everything is explained in standard HTML helper. If you are not aware of this, please watch that video first. Now we created one field, that is name. Now let us create one more field for address. So class is equal to form dash group @ html dot label for, sorry, label for m goes to m dot address, And here, now we are going to use text area. So text area for m goes to m dot address. Now if you want to apply the HTML attribute, then you can specify it using anonymous class. So form dash control. Now let us do it for email. So div class is equal to form dash group. In the same way, I have to say HTML dot label for m goes to m dot email. And at the rate HTML dot text box for m goes to m dot email, and then after the CSS class at the rate class is equal to form dash control. Okay, now next is we are going to accept a gender using radio button. So how will you do it? So div, again one class, form dash group. So whatever classes I am applying here, I already explained it in the bootstrap part 2. So if you are not aware of this, please watch the video of bootstrap part 2. So label for m goes to m dot gender. And for radio button, what we have to do, we have to wrap it in one div tag, and we have to apply the class to that div tag. Say you can apply radio or radio inline. If you use radio, your radio button appears vertically, and if you want horizontal radio buttons, in that case you can use radio inline. So let us apply radio inline. Now inside this you will create HTML tag, HTML helper, HTML dot radio button for, so m goes to m dot gender, and then after you have to pass the value. So for male, I want to pass m, okay, and after that you have to write here male. In the same way, we have to create one more such a div tag. So here I specify the value f and female. Okay, now we completed with this div. Now next is for password. So div class is equal to form dash group. Then at the rate HTML dot label for m goes to m dot password. Okay, and now password field. So for that we are going to use password for, and m goes to m dot password. And let us apply CSS class using anonymous class form dash control. Okay, and in the same way we have to create a password for one more field for confirm password. So label for, so as now you can, as you can observe here, whenever we are creating a view using strongly typed HTML helpers, we get an advantage of IntelliSense also. This is also one more advantage. And since we get IntelliSense, it is nothing but a compile time checking. Means, as you can see here, here I specified wrong property name. So it is showing that it is wrong. Okay. It is specifying that this is an error. So compile time checking is also done in case of strongly typed HTML helper, where it is not possible in case of standard helper. Okay. So that is one more advantage of strongly typed helpers. Okay, now we left with one more, isAgree. So let me add that one also. Class is equal to form dash group. Now div. So for checkbox, we have to wrap a checkbox in div, and we have to apply the checkbox or checkbox inline class. Okay, now there is only single checkbox, that's why I'm applying a checkbox class. If there are multiple checkboxes and if I want a horizontal arrangement, in that case we can use checkbox inline also. Now at the rate HTML dot checkbox for m goes to m dot is agree. Okay, now again if you observe checkbox HTML helper, look at to the right side, or what will I do? See, look at here, this first argument is of type register view model. And what output it gives us? It gives us output of type boolean. So what you have to remember here, so whenever you are using checkbox for, your property should be of type what? It should be of type boolean only, then only it will work. Okay, so I'll give a message here, I agree terms and condition. Now let us create one more div for our button. So div class is equal to form dash group. Now input type is equal to submit. Remember that there is no helper for submit button. So value is equal to register, and here I'm going to apply a CSS class, a btn dash default. Okay, so we're done with our form. Okay, and now what will I do here? We are not doing any processing, we will just check whether my data get collected in my model or not. So that's why I'm putting here breakpoint. Now let us run this. Look at here, your form get designed perfectly. Now if you observe the captions of a label, they are same as your property name. Means look at here, confirm password is what there, it was single word. Suppose you want space in between these, so you can use plain label or you can use standard helper, or I'm going to show you using stars strongly type HTML helper, how to manage this also. But that part comes under data annotation. So while studying data annotation, I'll cover that part also. Okay. Now let us observe the page source. See, form tag also get generated properly. Look at here, ID and name both are same, and they have the same name that our property has. Okay. Then address, email, okay, some extra tags also get attribute also get generated, that is data val required. Okay, we are going to study this part definitely, and in validation video. Okay, I'll cover this part. So whenever you are using any strongly type HTML helper, it also gives this kind of advantage. It automatically adds validation part also. So that is one more advantage of using strongly type HTML helper. Now again we'll switch. Look at here. So here also you can say for checkbox there are two tags. First one is input type checkbox, and another one is input type hidden. Okay. So I hope you got everything. Now let us see how it get collected or not. Say om, address say Pune, email om@gmail.com, say mail, password 12345, and I say I agree terms and condition. So here I already put a breakpoint. See, all the values get collected. Address Pune, confirm password 12345, password is also 12345, email, gender. Okay, on form I selected mail. Okay, and here also while designing a view, we specified that if you select a radio button mail, what will be the value? M. So same value get collected in our model. Is agree is true because I tick that checkbox. Okay, name is Om and everything get collected. So if you are using with strongly typed HTML helpers, it is very easy to write a code. Okay, as well as we saw the difference between standard HTML helper and strongly typed HTML helper also. Okay, it saves the searching time. Okay, you got an IntelliSense, there is a compile time checking, and it is very easy to use. So whenever you are going to use strongly typed view, go for strongly typed HTML helper. Again, this is not compulsion. If there is a situation or scenario that you need to use standard helper or plain HTML, you can go for this, or you can use combination of all the three. So I hope you enjoy this video. In next video, we are going to study a drop-down list part separately. Thank you.